morning children. Today we are going to see the word problems. In addition and subtraction, I had given you some keywords to find out which is the addition problem and which is the subtraction problems. And here for multiplication also I will give there is not a keyword, but the understanding the last part you will, when you understand, you will get the find out, you will be able to find out whether it is division or multiplication. Addition and subtraction both will be similar, and multiplication and division will be similar. Okay, in multiplication it will be asked for 1. I will give the hints to find out for multiplication problem. Given for 1, given for 1, and they ask for many. Given for 1 and they ask for many. And in division they give for many and ask for 1. Okay, if I explain then you will understand what it is. Okay, this is multiplication problem, this is division problem. Here you see there are 16 carpenters in a factory. If each carpenter makes 12 tables in a week, how many tables will be ready after a week? Okay, see here, if each carpenter, each means what? 1. Each means 1. So, 1 carpenter is making 12 tables in a week. Okay, so 1 carpenter is making 12 tables in a week. And here, how many carpenters are there? 16 carpenters. Now, they are asking how many tables will be ready after a week. So, after 1 week, how many tables will be ready? So, they have given for 1 carpenter. How many he will make the table. It is given for 1 carpenter. And now they are asking for 16 carpenters. Given for 1 and asked for 16. Given for 1, asked for many. Okay, understand now. Now I think you would have understood. Given for 1 and asked for many. If they have given for 1 and asked for many, means you will multiply. Many here itself we can understand. When you multiply only you will get the answer in big number. Division lesson you will learn. When you divide you will get the answer smaller than the question. Okay, in multiplication the answer will be bigger than the question, but in division the answer will be smaller than the question. Okay, so here given for 1 and asked for many means you have to multiply. Okay, now let me write the solution for this. For problems, compulsory statement is compulsory, and the calculation also you have to show. You cannot write the calculation in the rough work. Okay, how I am showing it, the same way you will do. And I am giving also the worksheet answers. I am giving exactly the same way you have to present your paper. Okay, so look at the way how I am giving the answers. The same way you have to give the answers. Okay, let us write the statement now. Now look at the statement. In a week, each carpenter makes 12 tables. Therefore, 16 carpenters make, this equal sign should be in the same line. So, 16 carpenters make 16 into 12 tables. You have to multiply. And this multiplication now, 16 into 12, you have to show here. You cannot write in the rough work here. Okay, rough work you cannot do. In the rough work you can write the table, but you will have to write the calculation here, and this statement also important. So now we have to multiply. This is multiplying by 2, so I think you don't need to write the table here. So 6 2s are 12, so 2 carry over 1, again 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 1 3. Now we are going to multiply by the tens place. The number is 1. So you will write the answer in tens place, and here there is no number, so you can put 0. Okay, now multiplying by 1 you will get the same number, only is the answer. So 6 into 1 6, 1 into 1 1. So now we have finished multiplying. Now we will add. Now so when you add, 2 plus 0 2, 3 plus 6 9, and here 1. Okay, so total is 192 tables. And last you have to take and write the answer. Therefore, 16 carpenters make 192 tables. Okay, therefore 16 carpenters make 192 tables. Okay, I think you have understood how to write. This is the same way you have to do in your copy also and in the exam also. Okay, now let's see the exercise now. Okay, this I am explaining from recap exercise. Recap exercise. Page number 140. Okay, this is on page number 140. Just I will explain, okay, how to find out it is multiplication. A basket contains 213 packets of chips. How many packets will be there in 6 such baskets? Okay, so it is given for a basket. A basket means one basket. Okay, and they are asking for 6 baskets. Okay, so given for 1 and asked for 6, so you will multiply. Next one, a utensil stand has 86 glasses. So a utensil, so one utensil stand, it is having 86 glasses. How many glasses will be there in 8 stands? So given for 1 stand and they are asking for 8 stands. Given for 1 and asked for many, so you will multiply. Again, a cloth hanger in a factory can hold 157 shirts. So a cloth, so this is one cloth hanger. It is having 157 shirts. How many shirts can have 4 such hangers? So given for 1 and they are asking for 4. So you have to multiply. This is in the recap exercise. And now we will go to the exercise. Okay, now we will see exercise 5.4 in page number 148. Only I will explain. I am not going to do this one. But in second sum, I will do some sums which is difficult. Okay, here the cost of a movie ticket. So, a means 1. So, it is given for 1 movie ticket. That is 65 rupees. And there are 363 people are buying the movie ticket. People bought the movie tickets. That means 363 tickets. 363 tickets. How much money was collected by the sale office by the sale of the movie tickets? Okay, given for 1, the cost of 1 ticket, and they are asking for 363 tickets. So given for 1 and asked for 363, so you will multiply. Now the second one, a typist can type 45 words in a minute. So in a minute, so in 1 minute, he is typing 45 words. How many words can he type in half an hour? So half an hour. So here the number is not given. Half an hour means I think you know it is 30 minutes. Half an hour means it is 30 minutes. So given for 1 minute and now they are asking for 30 minutes. Okay, half an hour means don't think there is no number. Half an hour means 30 minutes. 1 hour is 60 minutes. So half an hour is 30 minutes. So given for 1 minute and now they are asking for half an hour. 30 minutes. So you multiply this one. Next one, third one, one box contains 72 chocolates. So one box, given for one box, how many chocolates will be there in 19 boxes? So given for one box and they are asking for 19 boxes, so you will multiply. Next, fourth one, Sajit gets rupees 175 as pocket money per month. Per also one. So each also one, A is given also 1 and per is given also 1. So per month, for 1 month he is getting 175 rupees. What pocket money does he get in a year? So here is no number is given, but you know in a year. Year means what? 1 year, how many months? 12 months. So you will multiply by 12. Okay, don't be confused. There is no number. So what I will do? Don't be confused. So 1 month, 175 rupees. So 1 year, that is 12 months. 12 months, how many money he is getting? So these two you have to multiply. Given for 1 month, asking for 12 months. Next one, E. A bus travels 49 kilometers in 1 hour. So it is traveling 49 kilometers in 1 hour. How much will it travel in 36 hours? So given for 1 hour and they are asking for 36 hours. So you will multiply. Again, there are 643 houses in a colony. How many people live in the colony if each house has 5 members? Five members. So 643 houses are there and each house means 1. So in 1 house 5 members. In one house, 5 members means in 643 houses, how many members? So these two we have to multiply. So only this much is the multiplication problems. I think it will be easy for you. You can do. But the second one, it is mixed up of addition, subtraction and multiplication. There are three types of problems are there. Now how to find that I will explain. And which is difficult that I will do myself. Okay, now here you see the Statue of Liberty is 150 feet from its feet to the top. Feet to the top of the torch. Its pedestal is 89 feet tall. This pedestal rests on the foundation which is 65 feet tall. How high is the memorial in all? So it is asking in all. So in all, this word itself it says all. All means what you have to do plus. So this is addition problem. So the keyword all shows that it is addition. So you have to add now that height of the statue. That, its height from the top to its from the torch to the feet is 50. It is, see, number is not given. It is given in name. 150 feet. 150 feet. Again, pedestal. Pedestal means where that leg is. Where the leg is kept, no, that place is pedestal, that is 89. Again, the foundation. Foundation means from the floor to from the floor there is on the top till the pedestal, no, there is like a pillar is there, no, that is the foundation. So that is 65 feet. So total all these three you have to add. So this is addition problem. Okay, let's see the next. I think it is clear. You can see a teacher bought stickers for each of the students. There are 45 students in her class. She had brought 100 stickers. So 45 students are there and she has bought 100 stickers. How many stickers will be left with her? So left, the word keyword left. So this word says it is subtraction. So this one is subtraction problem. Again, an office building has 3 floors. There are 20 offices on the ground floor. There are 5 more offices on the first floor and 2 more offices on the second floor than on the first floor. How many offices are there in all? So this I will explain by writing on the this one board. Okay, next one. Maggie was playing with wooden blocks. She made 14 stacks, each containing 18 blocks. How many blocks did she use in all? So don't think that seeing this word all you have to add. Okay, here you see there is 14 stacks are there and each is containing. So one contains 18 blocks. So total how many blocks? So in one block, in one stack, 18 block means in 14 stacks. So given for one and asked for 14. So you have to multiply. Okay, this one is a multiplication problem. Again, next one, a florist earns rupees 575 daily. Daily means in one day. How much money will he earn in 17 days? So given for one and asked for 17 days. So this also multiplication problem. Again, Asha buys a washing machine for rupees 8,365 and an oven for rupees 4,935. How much money will she get back if she gives 15,000 to the shopkeeper? So this also I will explain. She is buying these two. So these two you have to add. Then that you have to minus from here. To the shopkeeper she is giving this much. So from here if you minus, you will get the amount how much she will get back. Okay, so these two, F and C, I will explain from in the board. Okay. Other things you can do, and Monday I will give the worksheet. So Saturday and Sunday do this exercise and the check yourself also. There is only few sums are there, so that also you can do, and you can do and practice. And Monday I will give the worksheet. Thank you.